Hey there, Aggies. Welcome to another episode of That May Be the Chancellor. Today, we're headed to our Sacramento campus. Come on, let's go.
In 1973, UC Davis purchased the land that is now its Sacramento campus. Formerly the Sacramento County Public Hospital, our Sacramento campus is home to two schools and two hospitals. The School of Medicine and Betty Irene Moore School of Nursing are both ranked in the top 25 nationally. The School of Medicine is also ranked as one of the top schools for student diversity in the U.S. Together with the UC Davis Rehabilitation Hospital and the nationally ranked UC Davis Medical Center, they are part of UC Davis Health, which is the second largest employer in Sacramento, after the state of California itself. Today I'm visiting the Aggie Square construction site to check on our progress. Aggie Square is our new innovation hub for undergraduates, graduate students, faculty, staff, and the neighboring communities. It's a partnership with the City of Sacramento and will open in early 2025. Aggie Square is expected to add nearly $5 billion a year to the economy of the Sacramento region and generate 25,000 jobs. Exciting stuff.
Hi, Claire.
Hi, Chancellor May.
How are you?
Good, and you?
Good, good to see you.
Welcome to the site. We're so excited to show you. We are all the way up to 7 stories.
Wow, so that is exciting.
If you're ready, we can put on a hard hat and some vests and get you up to the site.
Okay.
This is the grand gallery that separates Aggie Square proper from the nature preserve and the parking deck behind us. So we've got our innovation hall behind us, which has public facing event space, conference space, open seating, and then above it through the communicating stair that you see a hole in the ground for, that's where we have our large assembly event space.
Okay, great.
All right, let's go up and see it from above.
All right, let's do it.
My favorite part of the tour was, in addition to putting on my hard hat and boots, it was climbing the ladder to go up the very top of the structure and stepping on the rebar and pretending like I'm a real construction guy. It looks just like it looks in the drawings that I've seen. I can see where the buildings are going to be placed, and it's exactly like we envisioned it, and I can't wait to see it finished.
Chancellor May, thank you so much for coming.
Thanks for having me. Good to
be here.
Appreciate
you stopping by. We have a place over here if you'd like to sit down.
Okay.
Great. So we'll finish up now on some abdominal x-rays. Let's try to figure out what's going on. We'll open it up to the class, and then we'll talk about the case.
The students were so impressive. They have to know so much. Procedures, all the diagnoses. They seem to know everything.
That's really good. Okay. Chancellor May, thank you so much for stopping by.
Thanks for having me. I learned a lot.
Do you have any stomach pain? Because we're ready.
I know where to go if I do have something.
So tell me a little bit about yourselves.
For me, I chose PA because I wanted to make impactful changes like in my patients' lives. So we have flexibility in going to different specialties, which means like touching on like different populations and like being able to like build those relationships and actually make those impactful changes in their lives. So
great.
Yeah. Would you like to check out the building?
Yeah, sure, let's do that.
Okay.
All right, so Chancellor May, welcome. So this is what we call broadly our task room.
Okay.
It's a multi-use room. So here they would apply different methods for delivering oxygen. And then we did a demo on endotracheal intubation. What was your favorite lab so far?
Working as an EMT and working as 911, I've always seen, you know, during cases of cardiac arrest when we do have to see like do endotracheal tubes. It's a hard skill to master, but it's rewarding, you know, saving someone's life if you can master it. It's nice to see someone excited about the same thing that we are, that's interested in medicine and just the things that are typically used every day, actually. Every topic that we're going through right now, it's very interesting, just because it's brand new information or even things we've seen before. But now it's like we're getting into the deep of it, just understanding it and being able to like learn about it and even how to treat it.
Welcome everyone to our clerkship sim session this afternoon. I think we have a visitor joining us today who has arrived.
Hello, how's everybody?
We are about to get started. This is a simulation session that we do with the students rotating on their pediatrics clerkship every handful of weeks. We were hoping you would dive right in and help us with the case. Are you up for that?
Sure,
sounds awesome.
Like fun. All right.
Hi, my name is Marissa. I'm a medical student working with the team.
Thank you.
And my name is Gary.
So nice to meet you. Thank you so much for coming to help us. I'm really worried about Carl.
Yeah, could you tell me a little bit about what you're worried about?
2 days ago, he got a fever, which was new. And then yesterday, he really started to cough.
Have you noticed that he's ever like gasping for air or that he stops breathing?
No, I haven't noticed that.
You said he doesn't have COVID now. Has he had COVID?
Good question. We've been very careful with masks and vaccines. We've managed to avoid it so far. Why don't we move on to the pair that will do the physical exam?
Sounds good.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much for your help.
Thank you. These mannequins are so realistic. The mannequin was breathing and the mannequin coughed. That just goes to show how realistic these simulations are and how good teaching tools they are. Today was really fascinating. I really learned a lot, and I'm very impressed by our students and our faculty in the School of Nursing and the School of Medicine. The critical thinking they expressed and employed when they were trying to determine what was wrong with the patient, just very impressive.
It's fun to have someone who maybe doesn't get to see this world of simulation and medical education all the time. So it was great to have him come see what we do. This is a great facility that we have here for our medical students and other trainees and even faculty. So it's nice to be able to share it.
I always am so inspired by our students, particularly our UC Davis students have a real service orientation. Many of them go into primary care for underserved populations. I mean, I think that shows something about their character and their wish to be benefit to society.
I really like working with people, and I wanted to be in a profession where I would be like working in the community, like for and with the community, and like promoting health, which I think is what we all need to have a good quality of life.